her year mark is actually on 12/11, but we wanted to kind of skirt around the holidays, if possible. But God's timing is just perfect because of all the things that have happened this week. It's just really wonderful to be able to do this now at this time. So I'm going to open us in prayer, and then Tracy's going to come up and present Jennifer with a gift and share what God's laid on her heart. And then we will enter into worship, a time of worship with a song that staff has selected for Jennifer. And then we'll move forward with the actual foot washing ceremony, and then we'll play a song that Jennifer has picked. So that's how it'll go. Right.
I'll play for a scripture for Jennifer, and I just felt led that, you know, this was kind of sort of a commission to you. So I'd like to read this to you. It's in Colossians 3. It says, "As the elect of God, holy and beloved, put on tender mercies, kindness, humility, meekness, long-suffering, bear with one another, forgiving one another. But above all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection, and let the peace of God rule in your heart, to which also you were called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your heart to the Lord. And whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to the Father through him." And also in Colossians it says, "As you therefore have received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk in him, rooted and built up in him, established in the faith, as you have been taught, abounding in it with thanksgiving."
So back in the late summer, we attended a class together called Design, and I had the privilege of being a part of that for the first time, and with these ladies. And so through that, we were able to discover what our natural talents were and our spiritual gifts and our personality type. And we took everything that we had been through in our life and what God had put in us already to create us to his perfect design. And so I had put together something for Jennifer that just kind of puts all that in place for her so that she can always remember.
Splash of pink.
What's your favorite color? She said black with a splash of pink. Jennifer has a lot of natural talents. Some of her natural talents are communication. She is a people person. She loves to serve. She's a problem solver. And she has a lot of creativity. And I know with Resource and all that she does at Resource, I mean, they're always bragging on her, how she does such a good job there. Some of the spiritual gifts that Jennifer has is mercy showing, shepherding, and serving. And so she definitely is that here. She's almost been like a mom of the house as well, taking care of the other ladies. She just has a real empathy for others and wants to pursue that later on in her, maybe even a career in that later on. But her personality type, she has intuition. She's an extrovert. She feels deeply. Judgment, I mean, she has good judgment of character. And some of the things that her friends say about her is that she's strong, charitable, optimistic, confident. She's a loving mother. She encourages. She's intelligent, decisive, compassionate, hardworking, empathetic, loyal, and unstoppable. Jennifer's mission statement is to help others to see their value and steps to take to change their life. And so it's an honor for me to present this to you. And I'm going to put this on the back table back there. If everybody would just sign the back of it and maybe just write a little something encouragement to her. Jennifer's life verse is Proverbs 3:5, and it says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding."
Yes.
Everybody say faithful.
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 Faithful is our God.
Because like everything we do at Safe Harbor, we want to model after Jesus. And this is what he did at the end of his time with his disciples. So we're going to read this in scripture this morning. It's in John 13, and it says, before the Passover celebration, Jesus knew that his hour had come to leave this world and return to his Father. He had loved his disciples during his ministry on earth, and now he loved them to the very end. It was time for supper, and the devil had already prompted Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had given him authority over everything, and that he had come from God and would return to God. So he got up from the table, took off his robe, wrapped a towel around his waist, and poured water into a basin. And then he began to wash the disciples' feet, drying them with the towel he had around. So in our culture, this is weird. You know, why are we asking Jennifer to take her shoes off and let us run some water over her feet? But back then, this was customary. They didn't have cars. People were walking everywhere. Roads were not paved. They were dirt. They were the same roads that animals would travel down. So you can imagine what would be on the bottom of your feet when you arrived at your destination. And so here Jesus is in his last time, his last dinner, where he's sitting down with the men he has poured into and loved the most. And as he's doing that, their feet are dirty. And this is the job for the lowest slave in the house. Even, you know, normal servants would not clean feet because it was such a gross, dirty job. It would go on that TV show, Dirty Jobs, today. Okay, so Jesus gets up. And he does the dirtiest job. And he does it for a few reasons, I think. And so as I prayed about what to share with you today, God told me three little things. And it's going to be short and sweet, but I hope you'll always remember these three things. So the first reason that Jesus did this, and why we're going to do it for you, is because you're cared for. So Jesus loved his disciples so much, just like we love you so much, that he was willing to do whatever it took to clean them up and get them ready. And so that's where we sit with you. You are so precious to all of us in this room. I cannot tell you what an honor it has been to spend this year with you and to listen to your story and be a part of what God is doing. And you know, when this happened in scripture, Judas was sitting there. Jesus watched Judas's feet. And he knew, it says he already knew what Judas was going to do. And the reality is, we're going to fail. At some point, we're going to mess up. You know, we can't be perfect. And he already knows. He knows your darkest hour in the past. He knows your darkest hour in the future. And he still loves you and meets you there. And so you are cared for. That's number one. Okay, number two is you're clean. So what we're about to do, we're going to just have a visual symbol of what God has already done. And I will share with everybody, I remember a day when Jennifer came to sit in my office. We were going to have class, and we were talking about this thing called the three-part man. And we were talking about what it looks like to have a living relationship with Christ. And she just had this look, you know, and Jennifer gets this thoughtful look sometimes. And I said, Jennifer, do you think that you've done that? Like, have you already really surrendered your life to Christ? And in true Jennifer fashion, she was very honest, and she's like, I really need to think about it. And so she took some time to pray about it. And the next time we met, she's like, I know that I know that I know. It is squared way down. And so you are clean, my sister. You have been washed. There is no dirt. And as we wash your feet, it's to symbolize that there's no trace of the old road you walked on left. It's all gone. And then the last part, she's going to go ahead and start washing your feet.
Can I
see
her?
Okay, the last part of this, the last reason that Jesus washed the disciples' feet, and the reason we wash your feet today is you're cared for, you're clean, but you're commissioned. And so for the past year, it's been all about Jennifer, because we have poured into you everything we've got. Anything that was ours, you had access to, just like God does with us. But now, it's time for you to go pour into other people. You're ready. We know you're ready. We believe it. And it's time to serve. And we already see this happening with Jennifer. She has come over since she's moved to the apartment. There have been lots of times I hear her here, at times when she's not necessarily supposed to be here. And I'm like, what's going on? But she's here cooking dinner for the ladies, or just encouraging somebody who's new, who just moved into the house, or just being a listening to others. To raise up your sons to be godly men, it's never too late, and to shine a light in your family. So the last thing we want to do is we want to anoint you with some oil this morning before we pray over you. So this is Rose of Sharon oil. That smells real pretty. Smell it. Debbie found this. To serve in the way that God has called you to serve, and to do the things He's called you to do, and never to pick up the old things again. And last, because we talk a lot about our thoughts around here, we're going to anoint your mind that truth would be what reigns your mind, and that you would be absolutely captivated by Jesus in your thoughts. We love you. All right, so we're going to play another song, and Jennifer chose this song. And then after that, we're all going to come crowd up here and pray with her, okay?
She could move this heart to be set apart. I don't need to recognize the man in the mirror. And I don't want to trade your plan for something familiar. I can't waste a day. I can't stay